Oh yes, I still have a lot of goals and a lot of ambitions and a lot of things that I really believe that I want to achieve. Mm-hmm. Some of them I have the fear to do it, especially because of where I come from. So many other times I don't think I can do it. So this album is like a form of affirmation for myself, to tell myself that against all odds, beyond reasonable doubt, to tell myself that forget everything else, I'll fly.
Yeah. In spite of everything,
I'll fly.
You can still fly.
Yeah.
In spite of self-doubt and all of the things that can work to pull you back,
I'll fly.
You still got this.
Trust.
I like it. Yeah. How many songs on the album?
I have 17 songs.
Ooh,
on the album.
Yeah. 17.
Yeah.
How many collaborations?
We have Wiz, Davido, Kim Promise, Oxlade, Manifest, Omar Sterling. Jupiter as well. I thought Wizkid was the perfect guy on it. And then the beat also needed more beef.
Work.
And I, as time goes on, the sound becomes heavier and heavier. So the beat too for the make heavier and heavier. So I would say it took me a lot of years to do that whole Oh My Days record for Wizkid coming.
When did you finally get Wizkid?
I don't know, it's 2017 or 18, sometime like that. We were at Labadi Beach, just, you know, one of them casual days, and that was when I heard that I lost my mom as well.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
She rest in peace. Yeah, so I heard that, and I went home sad, came back, but because, you know, I had to come back to come and work, because I cannot let that break me down. I remember everyone was in the at Labadi Beach recording, making music and stuff, and then I'll be the only one acting like, yeah. So with tears in my eyes, everything, I just went to Labadi Beach, you know. I told them what happened. I was like, damn, man, that's sad. I cried. They spoke, they said what they'll say. We went back into the studio. I was like, I should play him a couple of songs. So we played a couple of songs. But this Oh My Days was one of the first songs that I played. So when I played it, I heard the whole song. I was like, wow, bro, this song is huge. I like the song so much, bro, and I think you're already even done with the song. But I'll bless you with the backings. So, like, from the beginning of the song, he just backed the whole song. Just put his voice in there.
He didn't do a whole verse?
No verse. He just did the backings of the song, just to add, like, the ambience.
Okay, actually.
Yeah. He kind of, like, created the ambience to the whole track record. He didn't really drop a verse in there. And I think that
Which
was
verse
did
you
best.
Want him to do?
That's all I, like... First of all, we've been creating a lot of songs, but that one especially was like, bro, I think it has this album called Sounds from the Other Side.
Mm-hmm.
It has a sound, and when he heard it, it was like, nah, this is giving me that sound. And it has some type of backings that he did on that album, that EP. It was like, nah, I'll do the same backing so that we have the like that Sounds from the Other Side effect. And that's what he did to it, and that was like amazing.
And that's the hardest song you've worked on
the
album.
Yeah.
You know, interestingly, when musicians talk about work that was hard or work that they enjoy from an entire body of work, it's usually born of just on-the-spot suggestions. Like, oh, you know what, let me just back it. Oh, you know what? Like, on-the-spot suggestions.
Yeah.
Usually, the ones that you really plan for into great detail, all right. But the ones that you just flow with are the ones that actually...
Yes.
Like,
there are some songs that are stubborn, you know, like some records are very, very stubborn.
What is a stubborn song?
You can start a song and then in the middle there you confuse.
So does that happen?
Hey, plenty times.
But a song is just 3 minutes.
Yes, 3 minutes. But some songs the 3 minutes can be years. That 3 minutes can take you years.
Huh.
Even the last time I was listening to that Lumbers interview, and he was saying the same thing about how it takes him years to record, and then how sometimes he has to go and be hanging with grown-ups or old folks, friends and stuff like that, for them to be saying like riddles and wise stuff, for him to go and put in the songs from time to time. Like, there are some songs that I can finish in like 1 hour, 2 hours, but there are some songs that can take years.
And the ones that you finish in 1 or 2 hours will probably not live so long.
That's the crazy part. You can never tell. You can actually never tell, because there are some of them that, like, you know, music is music.
Mm-hmm.
The older it gets, they're supposed to be sweeter. It's supposed to be sweeter.
What's that? Is there science to it?
I believe that, yes, if like a good music gets like, it's like wine, you know? And while the more it grows, the nicer it tastes. That's it's the same like that. I don't know how they say it, but like, yeah.
Good music is like wine.
Yeah.
The older it gets, yeah, it has the better
to age
it
like,
sounds.
It has to age like good wine. Yeah.
But isn't that dependent on the work you put into that good music in the beginning?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So some of the work can take you years. Some of the work, you can get so inspired, you can finish it in an hour or two. It's still the same work, oh, but it be vibrations. Some of the vibrations.
It be vibrations.
If I build them. Yeah.
I see. You know, yeah. I love talking to you because conversations with you are so rich with like all sorts of interesting definitions, words, and it'd be vibrations. I see.
Thank you so much.
I see. So is the album available on all streaming platforms?
Yeah. So But I Fly is available on all streaming platforms worldwide. Anywhere that you stream your music, whether YouTube, Apple Music, Spotify, Audio Mac, Boomplay, SoundCloud, Tidal, Deezer, every platform worldwide, just type Darkovibes, But I Fly, or just write But I Fly, and everything will show.
Okay, But yeah. I Fly.
But I Fly.
And it has 17 songs, it features over 8 big acts, and it has a bit of inspiration.
Yeah, definitely, the name of the album, There's Enough Space for Everyone in the Sky, is a form of affirmation. But if you listen to the songs inside the album, it talks about love, it talks about, you know, vulnerability, saying things that maybe top gangster, you know, go say I'm physically to some shorty because you're shy and stuff. Yeah, these are saying things that I've said in a record for you. So instead of saying it, you can just play it to shorty and then you're good to go. It's like Indomie. Yes.
It's like what now?
Indomie. I've just prepared all the words and then mix it up like a scientist. Just, you know, just play it to shorty and we are good to go.
I see. Yeah. Darkovibes.
Yes, please.
It's always lovely to vibe with you.
Thank you so much.
So, stream But I Fly, check it out, tweet about it, use it on your Instagram reels, use it everywhere. Let's make it fly because the album by itself is supposed to fly, okay?
Supposed
we don't keep it down, right?
Supposed to fly.
So that's
That's the sign, you know, butterfly, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, stay up.
Well, when you fly like that, we start associating you with Alan Chemantin's campaign, The Butterfly.
And also, you can also associate me with the New Day campaign, like
the butterfly.
More campaigns.
More campaigns.
More campaigns.
Always good to have you.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right, we've been vibing with Darkovibes here on TV3 New Day.